Hope she will be recovering soon. We all pray for a quick recovery. Now we move on to the next paper by Rupesh K. and Sooraj. Alamthuruthy Bhagavati.
Nagururathikam tattvam, nagururathikam tapa, tattvajnanat param nasti, tasmai shri gurave namah. My humble pranams to the lotus feet of Amma, Sadguru, Shri Mata Amritanandamayi Devi. Namaste. It is indeed an honor to be here in front of this august gathering. Me, Sooraj Subramanian, and my friend Rupesh Kaleshan from Amrita Vishwavidyapeetham, Kerala, are here to present a paper on the journey of Alamthuruthy Bhagavati. Here we are exploring a yatra which is connected to four temples, actually three Devi temples and one Vishnu temple. Here you can see in the screen, this is Alamthuruthy Bhagavati temple, which is situated in Pathanamthitta district of Kerala. You may know Pathanamthitta district because Shabarimala is situated there. And the other one is Sree Vallabha temple. It's a Mahavishnu temple. It's one among the 108 Divya Deshams of Sree Vaishnava. And two other temples are also in the picture. That is Padappadu Bhagavati temple and Karinattu Kavu Devi temple. Goddess Alamthuruthy. Alamthuruthy Bhagavati is Yogamaya, Mahamaya Devi. She is considered as Nandanandini. You may be familiar with that famous phrase in Devi Mahatmya. Nandagoba Grihejada Yashoda Garbhasambhava. The goddess who took birth in Nandagoba's house from Mother Yashoda's womb. That is Nandanandini, Yoga Maya. She is the younger sister of Sree Vallabha, that is Mahavishnu. And two other temples, two other devis, which is Padappadu Devi and Karinattu Kavu Devi, they are the divine consorts of Sree Vallabha, Mahavishnu, that is Sri Devi and Bhu Devi. One other speciality in this temple, Alamthuruthy temple, is Devi is considered as a small infant child who came from, you know, the Madhura, from Kamsa's hand. So she is considered as an infant baby. So even though in Kerala it's very famous that we used to have a lot of firecrackers and elephant processions in our temples, but here in Alamthuruthy, Devi is the little girl, infant baby is afraid of all these things, so we don't have firecrackers and elephants there. Here is the yatra. In the Mrigashirsha nakshatra, star of Malayalam month Meenam, all these three temples, three Devi temples, the festival will begins. It's with a traditional kodiyattam. It's called kodiyattam, which is the traditional ceremonial flag hosting with all these tantric rituals. After the kodiyattam, interestingly, all these three temples, it's the kodiyattam is in the exact same muhurta, same time. After the kodiyattam, from the second day onwards, Devi starts her journey. As I mentioned earlier, there is no elephants. Instead of elephants, there is a vahana. It's called shibika. That vehicle is called shibika. Shibika. It's almost like a palanquin. And two priests have to take on their shoulders. You can see the Ulsavamurthi is placed on the palanquin. And first day, she'll visit the nearby village called Vengal. There, the villagers receive her with various offerings. And she'll take a holy dip there in the Arat Kadav. It's called Arat. That holy dip is called Arat. You may be familiar with Avabhridasnanam, the word Avabhridasnanam. That will take place there. And after that, she'll, you know, to show that pleasure and joy and blessings, she'll perform a nritta. It's called Shibiganrita or Chivitakali by, you know, the two priests, they have to perform a dance called Shibiganrita with Bhagavati. Then after the Shibiganrita, she'll come back to her abode. And the second day, she'll again go to that village. Then she further proceed to the next village. Then all the rituals will take place there, and she'll come back. And the next day, she'll go to the next village. Finally, in the eighth day, she'll reach the seventh village, which is Thiruvalla, Sree Vallabha Swami temple. There are other two goddesses, which I mentioned earlier, Padappadu and Karinattu Kavu Bhagavati sir also will join with her. In the northern gate of Sree Vallabha, will open for these goddesses. And Sree Vallabha and Bhagavadis will enter to Sree Vallabha's abode, and Lord Sree Vallabha, which is Mahavishnu, he'll come out. His Utsavamurti will taken on a palanquin called Garuda Vahana. You can see the form of Garuda. He's carrying Sree Vallabha Mahavishnu on his shoulders. And Sudarshanamurti will also come out. And both the Bhagavadis will accompany Sree Vallabha and Sudarshanamurti besides. Alamthuruthy Bhagavati will, there is a concept like once Bhagavati, Sree Vallabha and Alamthuruthy Bhagavati, seen together, they look each other, then that gaze should not interrupted. So Alamthuruthy Bhagavati will proceed backwards. Like in that way, the pradakshinas will start. After three pradakshinas, that all these three goddesses will dance in their joy. It's called Shibikanirtam again. And after this Shibikanirtam, both Sree Vallabha and Alamthuruthy Bhagavati will enter to Sree Vallabha's Garbhagraha. In Kerala tradition, it is usually one deity will not enter to another temple's Garbhagraha, but here Alamthuruthy Devi will enter to Sree Vallabha's Garbhagraha, because both the Bhagavati, Yoga Maya, and Sree Vallabha is considered as two aspects of one Shakti, like the burning power and the fire and its burning power. After all these rituals, it's called Uttra Sree Bali because it falls on the Uttra Bhalguna Nakshatra of Meenam month, of Malayalam month Meenam. Then all these three Bhagavadis will go for the seventh holy bath, holy dip. Then she'll come back, they'll come back to the temple and they'll get back to their abodes, respective abodes. You can see she's going out to the northern gate. Okay, then Rupesh will continue.
Thank you, Sooraj. Just like the climax of a suspense thriller movie, I'm going to ask you a question. Does this yatra of Alamthuruthy Bhagavati ring a bell to you? Does it resembles anything at all? It's a question. Exactly. Somebody said here, it's like, remember, she's traveling on one day to one place, take a holy dip, comes back. On the next day, she will go again, cover some more distance, take a dip and come back. Third day, she will go again. She goes like that for 6 consecutive days. And on the 7th day, she reaches Sree Vallabha temple, where Sree Vallabha is the main deity. Both of them face each other. That gaze will not be interrupted. And both of them enter the sanctum sanctorum, Garbhagriha of Sree Vallabha. And the Ulsavam comes to a conclusion. Now, I guess you would have got it. It comes India, which is a land which has produced many symbols, which conceals very profound philosophical ideas, has here brought some very esoteric tantric tradition brought into a temple ritual in a very beautiful way. So we will explore that and we will try to brief it. So to tell about the Kuṇdalini comes from the root word kund, which means a deep place, cavity, or you can assume the root word kundal also, which means coiled up. So according to Tantra, there are many tantric references. Some of them like Tantra Raja Tantra, the serpent power, John Woodruff, many. Sharada Tilagam, Hada Yoga Pradipika, which also quotes from the verses 105, 106, 107, etc. About Kuṇdalini. So Kuṇdalini is considered as the latent dormant power inside a being in a jiva, which resides like it's sleeping down under the base of the spine. So now when you see, like when my friend Sooraj was telling, the Devi is worshipped in the form of an infant, and that's the reason why there are no firecrackers. could be, there could be another probable reason too, since it's a symbolic representation of Kuṇdalini. So the Devi, Alamthuruthy Bhagavati, is considered as Kuṇdalini, and since she is in a very sleepy mood, dormant way, that's why there are no firecrackers. This is not my assumption, this is the information which I have got from the male chief priest of that temple. So that's about Kuṇdalini. 5 minutes, yeah. So then there are about energy centers according to tantras. The numbers differ from different tantras, but assumingly, like, we can take 6 main important chakras or the energy centers, starting from upwards, Mooladhara, Swadhisthana Manipuraka, Anahata Vishuddha Ajna, and the Sahasrara Padma. And tantra says about different lotuses, imagining lotuses of different colors, etc. And then there are this Nadis, which are subtle pranic channels through which the electric current like prana flows. And the two prominent nadis are Ida and Pingala, which runs flanking across the Sushumna nadi, which runs through the middle of the spine. So this Ida and Pingala nadi here, which are considered as the solar and the lunar line of channels, are represented by the two other devis, which my friend Sooraj was telling. Anyway, we'll come to the comparison part. So here, Alamthuruthy Bhagavati, in fact, represents the Kuṇdalini Shakti of that village, of that desha. Padappadu and Karinattu Kavu Bhagavati represents the Ida and Pingala Nadi. And three of them will meet together after the on the seventh day. And 7 Aratu Ghats, means the places where they take the holy dip, comes back, represents the chakras. Sree Vallabha temple, indeed the Sahasrara Padma, and Sree Vallabha, the consciousness where the Kuṇdalini Shakti emerges, and Sudarshana as the Kriya Shakti, Kriya Power. So that's our actual title of our paper was Yatra of Alamthuruthy Bhagavati, a Vaishnava depiction of Kuṇdalini traversing through Shat Chakras. But if we keep the title in the beginning, maybe we cannot ask you that question in the middle, whether this resembles anything. So we intelligently removed that title. Coming to the conclusion, there are 3 main conclusions. One is Devi goes through these villages and bless the people there. The second thing is very beautifully, like, I respect the cultural intelligentsia of our ancestors, who has actually devised such a way where the otherwise esoteric tantric tradition is hidden. Now when the people participate in this festival, unknowingly, they are getting exposed to the some parts of the tantra. So let us acknowledge, appreciate the intelligence of our ancestors and take it forward. Thank you.